When I tried out the saw and changed the depth adjustment, I found some alignment problems, and checking it over, I had this hole in the wrong place, so I just glued a plug in there, and now I can drill it again, hopefully in the right spot. When I did my initial tests, I just put this screw in there to lock the angle. But now I need to come up with a different mechanism for locking the tilt. So I want to put some kind of locking knob here for the angle, and I measured the distance from the hinge here to the knob with my beam compass, and now taking that onto a piece of plywood, I'm being very frugal and using up some scrap, I marked where this arc will trace it. So this block with a bolt in it is going to get screwed onto here, and then this part fits on here, allowing me to lock the angle. Well, that makes for a rather large opening needed for all the angles, so I think I'm going to have to create some table saw inserts here. I have to say, dust collection on these fixed bases is way better than what you typically get on a plunge router like this one. So I just cut a bigger slot where the blade goes with my jigsaw. And that'll allow me to more easily get the blades in and out through here. So I just made a whole bunch of inserts to go into the slot here. I also made an on-off switch by basically just installing a switch on an inexpensive extension cord. So I can turn the saw on and off with this. And I bought myself a larger 8 1/4 inch blade, which is bigger than the 7 1/4 inch blade that these saws normally go with. And the reason I have room for a bigger blade like that is because I took this blade guard out, which fits around the saw, so basically the space occupied by this is now used for this. So that is 60 millimeters of depth of cut, or for those who like it complicated, it's about 2 3/8 of an inch. So that cut came out nice and shiny, even though this is just a piece of cedar. But then again, I've got a brand new finishing blade in here. When I made that rip cut, I noticed I had to put my temporary fence at a slight angle, so something was misaligned. And it turns out the saw blade was a little bit more like this compared to this plywood frame. It was off about 2 millimeters across the blade, which doesn't seem like much, but it's enough to mess up a cut. So I cut it out a little bit more here, and then jammed this a little bit tighter in here, and sanded down this block a bit more, and hopefully that should correct for that. Well, that's now square as best as I can tell. When I was testing the saw, I was getting a lot of sawdust coming out the front because as the sawdust comes off the blade here, it just comes out like this and basically hits me. So I made this little sawdust deflector, which will deflect it down. This is the sort of thing that would be very difficult to cut without a tilting arbor table saw. And the big dust ended up mostly underneath, so I guess my dust deflector in here kind of works. So I still need to make a fence and some means of supporting this thing, and I think I'll save that for another video.